या माई सेल्फ तेजस्विनी पीजी फ्रॉम बॉटनी डिपार्टमेंट विर्शो कॉलेज बेल्लारी. दिस इज माई सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द पाइनस एंड हियर वी विल सी अबाउट द टीयर्स ऑफ नीडल. प्रीवियसली इन द पार्ट वन आई हैव बीन स्टॉप्ड टिल द यंग स्टेम. नाउ आई विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग इट विद द टीयर्स ऑफ नीडल हियर. सो कमिंग अप दिस विद द पाइनस नीडल, वी आर वेरी फेमिलियर विद द टू टाइप्स ऑफ लीव्स हियर. वन इज अ स्केली लीव, अनदर वन इज अ फोलिएज लीव. And it is circular in outline in Pinus monophylla, semicircular in Pinus sylvestris, and triangular in this particular Pinus longifolia and Pinus roxbergia. So it means the needle shape is been differing from each individual species. This is to be noted here. So it is circular in one of the species called as monophylia. And another one that is a semicircular in the sylvestris, and the triangular in the longifolia and the P. roxbergi, etc. So it is differing. Coming to the outermost layer, they are having the epidermis, which consists of thick walled cells. This is very important here. The epidermis is thick walled cell, as it is one of the easy character. It is covered by a very strong cuticle. Stomata are found on all sides, so the needle is amphistomatic. Here the term amphistomatic should be remembered, where the arrangement of the stomata is seen throughout the needle all over, so that is called as amphistomatic. Many sunken stomata are present on the epidermis. Each stoma opens internally into a substomatal cavity and externally into a respiratory cavity or vestibule. So here, by the opening of the stomata, the exchange of gases are taking place. Below the epidermis, we are finding a few layer of thick walled sclerenchymatous hypodermis. It is well developed at ridges. And here we can see some in between the hypodermis and endodermis is present the mesophyll tissue, and it's not differentiated into pellucid and spongy tissues. We are very familiar where the particular leaf in the Pinus, we can see about the two types, that is a pellucid and spongy tissues are present, as they are called as mesophyll cells or the mesophyll tissue. But here it is not at all differentiated into spongy parenchyma tissue or the pellucid parenchyma tissue here. Coming to the next one here, few resin canals are also present in the leaf region, and they are mesophyll adjoined to the hypodermal region. Their number is variable, but generally they are two in number. Resins are present in all the species, but they are generally two in number, and in it differs from the species to species. Endodermis is single layered with barrel shaped cells and clear Casparian stripes. Here the endodermis is having a single layered with barrel shaped cells. Those are called as the Casparian stripes. Pericycle is multicellular and consists of mainly parenchyma cells and some sclerenchyma cells forming T-shaped grider. So here, when you take the section of the particular needle, the T-shaped grider can easily be seen under the microscope, which separates two vascular bundles. One is the transfusion tissue, consists of tracheal cells, and to join two conjoint and collateral vascular bundle are present in the center. These are closed by cambium, may also present in sections passing through the base of the middle. So xylem lies towards the angular side and the phloem towards the convex side of the needle. So far we have seen about these particular sectioning of the needle. So it is very clear here, this is a full structure. You can see the purple color one, that is a one particular section of the entire leaf. We are taken here the needle of the particular Pinus. And here, when you observe under the microscope, we are finding this structure here where the epidermal region is followed by the hypodermal region, and some of the here you can see the air cavities here. We can see the air cavities here, and they are arranged with these sclerenchyma cells also in between them, and the sunken stomata is very clear here in the section. See here in the lower epidermal region, and even in the upper part also you can see the sunken stomata or the amphiostomic condition can be seen in this particular section. Here it is one of the another picture taken here. See here the sunken stomata is very clear here on the upper and the lower condition of the particular cell here. Mesophyll lies below the hypodermis and it is not differentiated into pellucid parenchyma and spongy tissue. In the area here the green color completely it is filled here, and they are not differentiated is it a spongy parenchyma or the pellucid parenchyma. So that even we can see some T-shaped structure. See here, this is the bluish color where we are finding here. Here it is different, separated. Two things are getting separated. So that is a T-shaped in condition. And you can see here the thick waxy cuticle and sunken stomata are two structure updated, and the enabled pinus to retain its needle throughout the winter. So the guard cells of the sunken stomata, in this it is very clear, epidermis and the cuticle, resin ducts are also seen. See, as I told you all before, in this species, two of the resin canals are present. One is here and one is here. And endodermis is seen within the particular needle. Xylem arrangement and the phloem arrangement, the vascular arrangement is here where they are conjoint collateral type. And mesophyll cells, those are the photosynthetic parenchyma cells, are also present. So this is the needle of the particular pinus. Coming to the some of the characters here, it is having some of the xeric characters. It is very important to know about the xerophytic characters of pinus needle. So, it is narrow, acicular form of leaf, presence of thick cuticle, covering thick walled epidermis, amphistomatic nature. Has the amphistomatic nature indicates the presence of the stomata is seen on the both upper and even in the lower epidermal region. Sunken stomata is seen. This is an important character where seen in the xerophyte. Thick and sclerenchymatous hypodermis. Even it is having the thick and sclerenchymatous hypodermis. Many layered pericycle with transfusion tissue. It is the important one to be known. It is having the pericycle with the transfusion tissue. The pericular mesophyll tissue, that is the arm parenchyma. Even it is called as the arm parenchyma. And they are having the simple vascular system. So these are all the important character concerned with the xeric characters of the pinus needle. Coming to the next one, that is a reproductive structure of pinus. So as we are very familiar here, we know about the male cone and the female cone. So pinus plant is a diploid sporophyte. We are very familiar as it is having the dominant phase as the sporophyte. It reproduces asexually by spores. Cones are the asexual reproduction structures, and here pinus is the monoecious and unisexual. Okay, it is a unisexual plant. The male and the female cones are produced on separate branches of the same plant. So, coming to the male cone, here separate male cone from the cluster. Firstly, it is separating and its structure is cut long sectional. So the study is continued by taking the long section here. So the male cone develop in the cluster in the axial of the scaly leaves on long shoot. And next, they replace the dwarf shoot of the long shoot. So each male cone is ovoid in shape. Seeing the shape here, the male cone is ovoid in shape. It consists of central axis and numerous microsporophylls. So we are having two, we know about the two types of spores. One is a microspore and another one is a megaspore, where the microspores are seen in the male cone here. The microsporophylls are spirally arranged. Each microsporophyll is small leaf-like structure, and it has a short stalk with a terminal leafy expansion. The tip is sterile and it is called as apophysis. So this is important thing to be known here. It is the apophysis in condition. So here we can see that pinus clearly. This is the male cone, microsporangia, and the microsporophyll. Here the apophysis, you can see here it is a tip one, and the micro slit is present, and it is a stalk like structure where it is arranged here, and the sporangial wall. When you take the section here, tears of a microsporangium in the D here, you can see here sporangial wall, tapetum is present, which gives the nourishment to the pollen grains, and here the mother microspore, mother cells are also present here. It is the particular section when observed under the microscope, we are finding the male cone, which is filled with the spores here, which are embedded with the spores here, and each fertile microsporophyll bears on its lower side two microsporangia. It is having the two microsporangia. Each microsporangium consists of a mass of archisporial cells surrounded by 3 to 4 layered mass walls. So this is how we can see here. As I told you all, the microsporophyll is comparable with the stamen of the flower. Especially when we see in the angiosperms, it is very clear seeing the stamens, because it consists of a stalk and a filament. You can take a hibiscus as an example here, just for comparison, with a terminal leafy expansion, that is an anther, the tip of which is projected upwards and called as the apophysis. As I told you all before, the apophysis at the tip region. And the particularly two pouch-like microsporangial walls are seen. Those are present on the abaxial or undersurface of each microsporophyll. In each microsporangium are presented many microspores. So the pollen grains are seen outside when the microsporangium is completely developed. And each microspore or pollen grain is surrounded by a yellow colored light uninucleate structure with two outer coverings. So thick outer exine and the inner intan. If you are very familiar with the PUC, when we have seen that Vinca rosea, we are taken as an example there, and pollen tube can be observed there. So the outer exine and intine of the pollen grain is been seen very clearly there under the microscope. In the same way here also, the outer exine and the inner intine is also present. So the exine protrudes out on two sides in the form of two balloon shaped wings. Wings help in floating and dispersal of pollen grains. See, in the previous slide you can see here, this is a wing, intine and the exine here. It is marked here, number C, capital C, the winged pollen grain, and intine and exine. And even you can take the example as one of the calotropis. Okay, calotropis, when you take, you can even find the pollen grains there. We can practically do that. And wing help in floating and dispersal of the pollen grains. The mode of the particular function of these wings are to disperse the pollen grains. A few microsporophyll of lower side of cone are sterile. Sporangia are also not present on the adaxial surface of each microsporophyll of the male cone. So coming to the next, see here, we can see about the exine, intine, very clearly the pollen grain here, a few pollen grains and a mature winged pollen grain. Secondary prothallial cell is also present. First prothallial cell is also present. The pollen grain arrangement and the anthridial cell. two winged structure. Only in Pinus we are finding the particular winged pollen grain. This is very important to remember here. And moving to the next one, here the female cone. So in the center is present a cone axis. As that of the male cone, here also we are finding two types of the spores. One is the megaspores, that is a microsporophyll and the megasporophyll. Here megasporophylls are arranged spirally on the cone axis. A few megasporophyll present at the base and at the apex of the strobilus are sterile. So some are sterile, which are unable to fertile, and few are non-sterile, so that they are able to give rise to another plant. So megasporophyll present in the middle of the strobilus are very large and they decrease in size towards the base and the apex region. So the matured megaspores are seen at the middle region when compared to the basal or the apical side or the apex side. Each megasporophyll consists of two types of scales known as bract cells and oviferous scales. So here we can see in the particular image, that is a bract cell and the ebract cells. Yeah, it's clear here. So the cone, the ovule, oviferous scales, bract cells, and the central axis. This is the female cone of the Pinus. When we see under the microscope, staminated cone with the pollen. So here the pollen grains, the microspores or microchematophytes are seen here, where the pollens are placed inside. The pollen grains are seen here. So this is the female cone is having some of the structures here. And coming to the next one, bract scales are thin, has dry membranous brown colored structure, having finger upper part. They are also called as carifillary scales. Okay. And oviferous scale is present on the upper surface of each bract scale, and base of the upper surface of each oviferous scales are present two sessile and naked ovules. So this is how the female cone is seen. And we will clearly see about the ovule and the life cycle of the particular Pinus in the next upcoming slides. So I'll be doing with the part 3 in the next one. These are the things regarding the Pinus, starting from the needle of the Pinus till the female cone, male cone, and next we will see about the ovule and the life cycle, entire life cycle of the Pinus. Thank you.